Hi there, crafters. Welcome along to my channel. Thanks for checking out this video. It is a Scraptember video. It is for the 22nd and the prompt is for family. So in 2024, I was lucky enough to celebrate my 40th birthday, and I'm not much of a sort of party or a social person. I'm a bit introverted. So I do sometimes prefer the company of, you know, one or two people or just my closest friends and family. But I did go to the trouble of having a party, and I had a pink themed party, and I wore the most beautiful gold dress just to sort of stand out a little bit and be quite individual. And of course, a 40th birthday is a milestone, so I had some photos taken with my parents and my brother and all my friends and family and my own family. And so today I'm scrapbooking this photo, which is of me with my parents, and that's going to make up the family portion of today's post. So this particular collection, I believe, was a Kidaholic kit. I couldn't tell you from what month or year, but I'm loving sort of these pastely colours. I think they stand out really nicely behind the brightness of the photo. And there was lots of tags, so I really wanted to use tags as a fairly large piece of the clustering. And you can see that behind my photo, what I'm doing is just adding elements in terms of pattern papers. I'm inking around some of the edges just to give a bit of dimension and separation, and I'm adding those sort of little florals and some tags as well. I have also, from the bag that this came in, and I'm pretty sure it was a Kidaholic kit, so the bag that it came with had the embellishments as well, and it had the florals. Now I am choosing to use a pre-made Vicky Booten background, and this is for a number of reasons. It's for stash busting, but it's also a little bit to do with trying to get some Scraptember videos done and not being sort of locked into creating my own mixed media backgrounds. So this particular Vicky background, like that pastel colour, it is so not me. Like, I'm a brights kind of person all the way, as you can tell from the pictures from my party. But definitely lent itself really well to this collection. I think it was perfect, the way the pastel softness of those elements tucked in behind the photo sat really well against that background. Now, I pulled the florals because I don't use florals very often. So if I'm going to scrap a layout about myself, it's probably going to have florals on it somewhere. And I really want to use the florals because it's not something I use very often. A lot of them tend to sit in my stash. So in this case, because I have the opportunity to use them, I want to make sure that I'm getting them on the page. All right, I did put this aside for a little bit of time to have a think about it because I did like what I had, but I couldn't work out what to do next. And so I'm going to take my super technical tool, which is my dinner plate, and I'm going to draw a circle in the background. And that's going to give me a little bit more of a back to work with. So I knew that some of this would get covered up, but I wanted to kind of have that area where I could place those florals and still have it draw the eye towards the photo. Now, once I'm happy, I do decide that I'm also going to add some stitching around that circle because it's getting a little bit lost in the florals and the photo cluster there. So I need to stick a few things down, and then off camera, I'm going to go ahead and add some stitching. Now, if you've never stitched on a layout, I do mostly hand stitching or machine stitching, but it just depends on what you prefer. And if you need a tutorial, I would definitely suggest going to YouTube. There's heaps of people out there that can teach you how to hand stitch on a layout. That's where I learned to do this sort of chain stitch that I've done on this particular page. Now, happy with how this is looking. I really like the circle. I like the little florals. I am, of course, going to go with a super simple title in the word family. So I didn't want to overcomplicate it. I just wanted to add that sort of simple memory for myself and make this my family layout for Scraptember. So that is the completed page. I thank you so much for watching. I hope that you have enjoyed this. Scraptember has been super fun and I'm really enjoying it. So if you haven't already, I would love if you subscribed and of course always leave a comment. I love to read them.